Hi guys, I'm Rahul and welcome back to Fwrapper Aqua. If you're visiting my channel for the first time, please do consider subscribing and we regularly make videos on discus keeping, plant tanks and marine tanks. So this video basically is about culturing microworms and grindleworms. So basically culturing them out at home is really good, so you don't need to have major sterilization, or you can actually trust the source because it's made in your house. So it's really good. So microworms are actually very good for your fries if you have babies and stuff, so I use them for my discus babies. Grindleworms actually for the bigger fishes, and like I feed them, they like it. So yeah, so this going through all of this, I recently came across this website called microworms.in, where I picked up the starter kit for microworms and grindleworms. They are based in Bangalore. So then I picked up these two things. So this video basically is about the unboxing of what you get for both the starter kits, and I'm also going to be showing in this video the how to start off the microworms culture. I'm also going to be leaving a link in the video's description. So if you guys are interested in picking up things from their website, they have a lot of other varieties of food. So definitely do visit their website. It's called microworms.in. I'll leave the link in the description. So please do have a look and stay tuned, and see you on the other side. Purchase at microworms.in. These are the two boxes that I received at my place, since they are based in Bangalore. So this is the grindleworm and microworms culture, and this is, I think, got the cocoa pit and yeast. So let's unbox and see how this whole project and whole process goes. So the box has got some ventilation and all. This is the grindleworms culture. This is some sample yeast which they have given us, and this is the microworms culture which is there in this silver foil. They have also given some dog food to basically start off the whole process. You can see the worms inside this. I'm doing some nice ventilation here. So there's quite a lot of worms in this, since it was delivered by hand, since they are based in Bangalore. So similarly, they'll be sending similar quantities even when you're sending outside Bangalore, but most of them will not survive. So you might get about half the quantity once you receive the package. See the worms inside, and yeah, see the worms moving. It's nice, very interesting. I've never done all this. So now let's open the other box and see what else is there. So this box has got the cocoa pit and the yeast, what is required for making the culture. So I've asked for two cultures, so they'll be, I'm guessing. So I've asked for two cocoa pit box, so that's why the box is a little big. So generally you get only two, so I've asked for two more. So this is the cocoa pit cubes, and this is the yeast. This is all what you get when you buy a starter kit. So what you saw in the first box was the starter kit, which has got the grindleworms, microworms and dog food and little bit of yeast. So since I wanted to have to make more culture, so I have asked for extra cocoa pit cakes, and this is a 50 grams yeast packet. So this is all additional apart from the starter kit. So let's start the process and see how it goes. So these are all few things what you need to start the culture. So you need two food containers. This is reused food containers. You guys can
clean it out and use containers what you get food and parcels of things. So containers with lids, very important, two of them. A bowl, a spoon for mixing the oats. This is the yeast what came with the kit. This is the microworm starter kit, and you need the non-flavored oats. That's very important, no flavors, just plain oats. That's what you need. So let's start the process. So we need about 5 spoons, this is a small teaspoon. We need about 5 spoons of oats. And oats, very specifically, no flavor, non-flavored oats is what you need. So this is not enough actually for one culture, so we'll add another maybe 5 spoons. So this is a good quantity for both the boxes. Now we need to add normal drinking water, just to soak the oats. So basically the oats needs to be fully soaked in the water. So after some time the oats will kind of expand and become like a thick paste. So this is the consistency that we need to achieve. So like mashed potato or baby food kind of consistency. You can see that slight thick lump of this formed. This is what we need to achieve. So in case you poured more water, you might have to add little more oats to get this consistency. You can see this lump kind of thing. That's what we need to achieve. So once you achieve the consistency, we need to take the yeast what is given. Very little yeast needs to be used, because excess of yeast will cause a biofilm which actually reduces the oxygenation in the culture. So you need to take very little. So you can take little in your hand and just sprinkle it for the oats. So for so much, only this much of yeast is required. So they have given quite a lot in this packet. It's not to be used fully. It's very, very little. That is what we need to use, because excess of yeast, like I said earlier, will cause this biofilm where it will reduce the oxygenation, and this needs to be mixed well with the oats. So mixing of the yeast and oats is very important. And no excess usage of yeast. So now this is ready. So now we have the yeast and oats paste ready. So we will fill the containers up. So important thing here is we shouldn't touch the side walls when we are filling. So we should keep the oats to the bottom portion itself. So you should try and avoid touching the sides, because on the sides, side walls is where the microworms actually culture. So it's more easier when you want to take them out, you can just take out from the sides. So the bottom portion should be the only place where the oats and yeast mixture is going to be there. So let's fill it up. I'm going to be splitting this equally into both the containers. So try and put it only in the center, so automatically the oats will spread out to the bottom. Some new things which I'm trying, making food for my babies. Hopefully everything goes well. So we've added the base, so just tap it so it settles. So So this is a thin layer which has come. So this is actually more for this container. Because of the yeast, what happens, it will expand, and I think in a day or two, what was told to me, that it will expand and it will reach this level. So this is okay for now. So this is the kind of thing what we need to achieve. So nothing stuck to the sides of the walls of the container. So yeah, there is little bit here that I'll wipe off. First time, so can't be perfect. We need to get used to it. So now our base is all set. So let's open the starter kit what was given to me. This is one Ziploc cover. It's got another small Ziploc cover inside. That's done for safety in case this leaks, so the culture still remains inside. So this is our microworm starter kit culture. So since it's a Ziploc cover, and this needs to be split equally into both the containers. So what I'm going to do is, I'm not going to open it from here, I'm going to cut it from here and just spread it across to both the containers. It's like sauce, mayonnaise. Again to the center, not to the walls of the container. Be careful when you're adding. Now we've added, this needs to get mixed with the oats and this one's base. So I don't know if you can see, you can see the slight movement. Can you see, can you guys see, that's the basic worms which is going to grow on the yeast and the oats mix. That's how small they are. Nice. So now I'm going to just tap it like what I did earlier for them to just settle. With this tapping, they will slowly spread across. And they will get into the base. So what I heard from microworms.in, the website, and a good friend now, Arun, is that these cultures will last for about 10 days. So because I'm starting off, so I'm using two cultures. So next culture, when I'm starting off, it should be, there should be a gap of about 5 days between each culture, so that you have, even if one fails, you have another one running. So simultaneously we'll have to plan that out and make that kind of arrangement. So if you start one today, then next you should start after 5 days. So ideally you have two cultures, one which is very young and one which is about little old. So the crash rate is very, very low, so that's better to plan it out that way. Now what we need is, we need to close this with the lids of the containers. So if you guys have an ant problem in the house, you need to just leave it as is, just close it airtight is fine. But with that, what you'll have to do is, every day you need to open it at least once in a day during this culture process. So you just need to open so that there is oxygenation in the container. So if you don't have an ant problem, you can just make very small, very, very small holes just for the air to get in. So that is very important. So now I'm going to just close it because I have ant problem in my house. So I'm not making holes. So yeah, just make it a point to seal it properly. I mean, the container is locked properly. It has to be kind of airtight. And now we need to wait. So the idea of using a transparent container is that so you can see the growth of the culture on the walls after a few days, you will see it. So if you use a dark container, we will not be able to see, so we will have to look through it from the top or in the center. So it's always better to use a transparent container so you can see the growth, the culture growth. And all you need is, you don't need any light for this, it just needs to be kept in a cool and dry place. About 25 degrees kind of Celsius, normal room temperature is fine. So let's see how this whole process goes. Yep. So for reference, what I'm going to be doing is using a sticky note to just remember when we started the harvest. So today is the 20th. Now today both have started together, so there's no issue. So next when you're starting, so you can use a small sticky note so you know that. So we generally have a tendency of forgetting dates when we started. So you can put the date, like I said, the gap between two harvests should be about 5 days. So you can put dates and then, so it's easy for you to remember which is what. You can see that the worms have grown and climbed up. So this is how it is. So you can use a small earbud piece to actually take this out and feed it to your babies. So it's been some time. I was traveling and all that, but this culture has not failed. So I need to start a new culture now. But these are all good. You can see the worms. So live microworms. So it's grown on all sides of the container. Let's take some and feed to my babies. But the problem is when I feed them, you cannot actually see it in my tanks because my tank, all tanks are white background.
So hope you guys like this video. If you did, give us a big thumbs up, like and share our videos, and please do drop in your comments and let us know what you think about this video. And like I said earlier in this video, I'm going to be leaving the list in the description of this video, microworms.in, their link. So please do visit their website and stay tuned for the next video where I'm going to be showing the culture and how to start off the culture for grindleworms. So stay tuned, and like I always say, this hobby is really fun, guys, if you do it the right way. Cheers guys, love you all, bye bye.